here's something new. This is Mr. Donuts, right? This is, I think it was originally from America, the donut chain. I don't know. I think. Anyhow, it's a big donut chain in Japan. So, this is Mr. Donuts ice cream bar. So it is the old fashioned. The chocolate dipped, right? So they call it the Choco Fashion. Supposedly this ice cream tastes like it. This is actually probably my favorite. Actually, I like the Old Fashioned glazed one, but I haven't seen that in a long time. The Mr. Donuts in my town is gone. And it closed down like several years ago because I live in a small town. And, which is sad. So the only time I ever eat anything from Mr. Donuts is if I go into the bigger cities. Alright, so I'm gonna try this.
I've had this ice cream bar since I was a child. People always trying to take it from me.
It doesn't taste like Mr. Donuts at all. So I got one of these for my daughter. And as she was eating it, I'm like, hey, does it taste like Mr. Donuts? She said no. And now I know why. I was expecting it to have like the taste of like a donut, like little bits or something inside here. Well, this is just basically just vanilla ice cream that's dipped in chocolate. And I mean, it might be the same chocolate as this, but it doesn't really give that like the real feel for a donut. I mean, it's all right, but there's no point in differentiating this with. Although, I don't know. It might have some bits in there. It just doesn't taste really that strong, though. And I'm looking at, there's like a little bit of texture in there. I don't know. I don't really get a sense for it, but I mean, it's okay, I guess. All right, so Hoshi no Kirby. Yeah, it's Kirby and it's gummy candy, and it's 4D gummy. Oh my gosh, really? Wow, 4D. What do you have to say about that, huh? Okay. Well, let's take a look here. I'm not a huge gummy fan, but you know, Japanese gummy candy is pretty great, I think. And here we go, and oh, there's Kirby, and he looks kind of angry. Maybe somebody dented his car or something in the parking lot. I don't know. Does he drive? You know, I don't think I've ever played a Kirby game in my life. Yeah, I'm ashamed to admit that. And it's peach. Yeah, it says right here, peach flavor, yeah. So this is made by Bandai Namco. Isn't that weird?
Okay. Alright, now, this stuff is freaking cool.
It's freaking awesome. This is that Gundam show I don't know or care about. Oh, and this is the Gundam. I did this another, I think my previous video. Alright, so this is corn pottage. This is like a corn cream soup. Alright. Seriously, I don't even know what this Gundam show is called. It says Gundarm. What's up with that? But anyhow, this has already been eaten. This one is salt flavored. Alright. The same flavors as last time. This is roasted corn flavor. Alright, this has like a Zach looking thing up here. And I don't know what this show is. What is this show? The Witch from Mercury. Oh, that's weird. No idea. Is it good? Have you seen it? I don't know. Let me know. The characters look kind of dumb, I think, for Gundam. The best flavor is the cheese flavor. We've bought several of these. My wife likes this a lot, too. And speaking of Gundam, I picked this up at 7-Eleven. This is a Gundam double candy. Oh my gosh, it's double. So you got cola flavored and soda flavored. And oh my gosh, it's got a scene from Gundam. So this is the original Gundam. This is a Gundam that I like. And let's take a look at what we have inside. And I don't like opening it from the side. It's kind of dumb. There we go. Let's open this up. And each piece of candy has a scene from the original Gundam TV show. All right, here's Amaral. This is Captain Bright getting angry at Amaral, as always. So let's just open this up. And this is the soda flavor. Huh. And that's pretty good. That's yummy. This is Amaral taking a nap. I don't remember that happening, but I'm sure it happened. There's Sayla. She's beautiful. And there's Gundam. There's Amaral looking surprised and such.
Okay, isn't that cool?
I think it is cool. So there's no stickers or anything inside, I don't think. Just candy. And there's another one of Sayla. Isn't that beautiful? So yeah, neat crap. Something else is really great. This is Moss Burger Potatoes. This is like a French fries. Cheese teriyaki burger. Torotama. What is the Torotama? I don't know what that's about. Anyhow, it's got Gouda cheese powder. Isn't that beautiful? And this stuff is really good. I had this with my wife. Yeah, it's really great. So it's just like the little sticks. I'll open this up. I dropped it twice. Oh, you don't want to eat that. And here you go. Mmm, freaking yummy. Oh my gosh, yum. Yeah. Bulgaria yogurt with... Oh my gosh, it's Luke Skywalker. Oh my gosh. So there was another one. It was, it had Grogu. But I got Luke Skywalker. Because I like Luke Skywalker. And that's it. It's just plain Bulgaria yogurt. I don't know why. They just had a Star Wars campaign. And I'm like, you know what? I got a coupon, so... Or not a coupon, but a discount, so... Why not? Why not? Right, so Korean food is kind of all the rage, I suppose, these days. This is Yanyeom Chicken Ramen. So, currently, 7-Eleven has Yanyeom Chicken. It's like a... It's like a, you know, spicy, sweet and spicy, like fried chicken, I guess. And here it is in ramen form. So, yeah, it's made, you know, it's the chicken ramen series. This is by Nissin, and oh look, it's even written in Korean, dude. So yeah, I'll have to try this sometime. I bought it for when I go into work and I don't have a food to take with me. So this is a premium chip star. And this is ebi nori. So ebi is shrimp, nori is seaweed. And it's Super Mario. Look at that. Chip star. Isn't that great? Alright, I'm gonna try this. Oh, I'm gonna try this. Oh look. Oh look, it's got that cool design. There's that, like, the one-up mushroom or whatever. There's the fire flower and the coin and crap. That's cool. There's the stars. The block, that's cool, that's cool, that's cool. Alright, let's open this up. Oh! Alright. Okay. Yeah, I can taste the shrimp and the seaweed. So, there you go, Super Mario. Now. Spy Family. This is Cafe Olé by Coffee Boss. Alright, but look, peanuts. So this is a pleasing aroma. And yeah, there's a Anya Waku Waku. There's an Anya Forger. And there she's riding that big old dog. You know, it sucks because, like, season 2 came out and it finished up in December 2022. The new movie's not, it's not going to be out till like December 2023. So they're making us wait an entire year. An entire year, my gosh, it's torture. I mean, I guess I could read the manga, but, you know, whatever. So there's Anya, isn't that cool? So, peanuts flavored coffee? Alright, well, I'm going to have to put this in the refrigerator. Right? And then try it, maybe tomorrow morning. So here's Lloyd. What else we got here? So, and there's Yor. She's pretty. Oh my gosh, she's the... The mom. If you've never seen the show, you gotta try it. You gotta look it up. I mean, come on. Take it from me. I don't even like anime hardly anymore these days. I mean, most modern anime, I just don't... I can't get into. But... No, it's the same. Spy Family, though, it was really fun. Oh, there's a goofy Anya face. It's a really fun, cute anime show. And there's Yor again. And then there's the goofy face. So, yeah, I'm gonna put this in the fridge overnight and give this coffee a try tomorrow morning. See what it's like. So I confirmed with my Japanese wife that there is no actual peanuts in here. And, because it says peanuts. And there's no peanuts listed in the ingredients, though. So I think it might be just the smell. Maybe it might trigger a type of a peanuts flavor because, you know, your sense of taste is pretty much built off of your sense of smell. So let's give this a shot. This is the weekend morning now. It does taste like peanuts. It does. Which means that it's just got some weird, probably just some weird chemical or something or other in it that gives it the peanuts smell, which makes it taste like peanuts, but it's not actual peanuts. This is a weekend morning. I went and picked this up. Family Mart. Donuts. These are French Crouler donuts. My daughter likes these, so it comes in like regular plain and chocolate. Yum. Okay, so now it's September, and I got some strawberry and chocolate. So this is Kinoko no Yama and then Takinoko no Sato, right? These feature the Urusei Yatsura characters, right? So let's look at this one first. So there's Lum, Ran, and what's his name? He's an asshole. But yeah. That's a pretty cool looking UFO right there. Gosh, what's his name? Ah, shoot. Oh, well. I can't remember. Oh, Ray. His name is Ray. That's right. He's featured on the back there. Oh, there's no stickers or anything in here, unfortunately. You just get the snacks here. So this is more like a cookie. It's pretty good. And this is more like a Pocky type of pretzel or something. Different textures, and we got benten on the back here. So these are pretty awesome. I got these, picked these up. My daughter's already plowed into these. There's a few left though. So yeah, freaking cool, neat. Spy Family nuts bone. It's got a little bit wet because I bought some cold stuff, some cold drinks. Well, anyhow, it has this really faux retro kind of look to it. It looks like it's like faded or something. It's kind of interesting. So it says Saku Saku peanuts, like crunchy peanuts, and it's got caramel candy on the inside. Oh my gosh. Is this good or not? I don't know. I was never really big into Kohi ni Pitari? Goes well with coffee, apparently. I would not know. Okay, so you look for the Forger family. I don't know. Well, anyhow, let's open this up. I used to hate peanuts when I was a kid. And, well, look at that. Look at that. So, this is what it looks like. And it smells like peanuts. That's what it's, that is. Okay. It's not bad. Then on the wrapper. There's her toys. All right, Anya, so there's actually two packages. There's like this one, and the other one is like has her with her little goofy eyes. All right, when she's squinting her eyes. When she's got an evil plan or something or other. It's actually pretty good. Wow. All right. Well, let's say you want to pretend to be healthy. It says Yasai Ichinichibun, or one day's vegetables. So, uses no sugar and there's no salt. Alright, no, that's great. My wife says that these drinks are no good because they boil the vegetables and it removes a lot of the vitamins. I don't know. Well, that's definitely orange. That is definitely orange. Yeah, that's great. I think the Yasai Seikatsu, which is like really, it's a popular brand like this, and I think they might use salt and sugar and stuff for flavor. But for your healthy daily life with vegetables, Yasai Days, Vegetables Days, focusing on vegetables you need, we offer a delicious vegetable taste. Enjoy a refreshing taste. Isn't that nice? Alright, more Spy Family candy. Anya Ame. Anya Waka Waka. So this is the fruits mix. This is not peanuts flavor. It's Amazupai fruits mix. So it's sweet and sour. Now, check this out. Alright, I can open up that way. Okay. And it's a little hard candy. Isn't that great? And. I can really taste pineapple. So. Wait. It's got strawberry, peach. Oh, it's not pineapple. I guess I'm crazy. Yeah, never mind. That is definitely peach. Yeah, that's pretty good. Oh my gosh, here we go. Look at this. Kinoko no Yama and Takenoko no Sato. Again, Urusei Yatsura. But this is Amasa. So this is less sweet chocolate, not quite dark chocolate, but I think it's pretty close, I guess. And yeah, so this has is it Fujinami? Who's this again? I can't remember. Some tomboy, I guess. Can't remember that character. And here's 10, the obnoxious one. So yeah, these are my my daughter's favorite snacks. Actually, she likes the Takenoko better than the Kinoko, because this is more of like a cookie and this is more like a cracker type, pretzel type thing. But yeah, here you go. So yeah, neat stuff. I just found this today. It's October, so last month they started with the strawberry chocolate, and this is just like the bitter chocolate. So yeah, neat stuff. Oh my gosh, it's Halloween. Here's some spooky cotton candy. Look at that ghost. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And here's some scary pocky sticks. They're just chocolate pocky sticks, but it's got cute little ghost monsters and stuff. Let's take a look inside here. Let's open this. Look at those bats. Isn't that scary? That's so cool. The little jack-o'-lanterns. That's cute. It says lovely Halloween. It's not scary. It's lovely. Same. Oh, cute ghosts. That's great. Mentai butter flavor. Potato chips by Calbee. Isn't that interesting? This is a... I bought this at Family Mart. The thing I don't like about this, though, it says potatoes, jagoimo, right? But it says made in Japan or America. Well, which is it? Right? And it doesn't say that there's no GMO. So I'm not happy about that. Not happy about that. But, all right, let's give this a shot. So butter, mentai. Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. Mentai is like a cod roe, right? So the cod, yeah, here we go. Here's a picture of it. So it's actually really good, despite what you might think. So shut up. This is good. That's great. I'm happy about it. That's nice. That's nice. This is La France Chuhai. Now, this is one of those stupid things that Japanese people say. They don't say it's a pear. Now, the Japanese pear is called a nashi, and nashi, it's more like an apple, but it doesn't taste as good as an apple. I don't really like nashi. I mean, I'll eat them, right? It's not like I hate them. There's just nothing remarkable about them. Don't really care. But pear is more, it's actually Yonashi, which is like a Western nashi. But they also say La France. I don't know why. I mean, I'm not saying that, you know, Americans say stupid things too, of course. I'm not saying that we don't, but this is just an example of kind of a dumb word that Japanese people came up with. So anyhow, this is a Chuhai, pear Chuhai. And it's from Yamagata Prefecture, right? That's where it's made. And, it's got 1% fruit juice and 4% alcohol. I can't remember where I bought this or when I bought this. I found this in the fridge, last weekend. I'm like, oh, crap, I forgot I had this. Totally forgot. I probably bought it at the Welshia, drugstore market. That's probably where I buy a lot of booze, I guess. Either that or the other drugstore, Aoki, whatever it's called. Well, let's give this a shot, guys. That's great. That is great. So, this does not have any high fructose corn syrup. Or any sweetener really at all. It just uses the fruit juice as a sweetener, and I appreciate that. I mean, it's got like caramel coloring, and you know, that's not so good. And chomidio. It does have some flavor enhancers, which are not good, but at least it doesn't have the sugar stuff. It's made by Asahi, by the way. Oops. There we go. All right. Italia. Choco. This is Italy. I think this is what Italy's supposed to look like. I wouldn't know because I've never been there. Obviously, this is not Big Ben. I'm ignorant. I mean, whatever. I guess it would be kind of silly if they put the Leaning Tower of Pisa on there because... maybe it's just too obvious. Well, anyhow, this is tiramisu flavor, right? Do you like tiramisu? Yeah? Well, anyhow. I like it a lot. Yeah, and I'm going to just try this out and see if I like it. So, this is, mascarpone cheese down here. And it's got chocolate coffee on top. Oh, really? Well, let's try this out. Pretty good. Actually good. It's good. Well, it tastes like definitely tastes like tiramisu, and I love tiramisu. It's my favorite dessert. So, yeah, that is really nice. Yeah. Oh yeah, it says Globetrotter Travel Guidebook. Arukikata.co.jp. Well, whatever. I don't know about that website. I'm not going to look because I don't care. But this stuff is pretty yummy. Yeah. So, Pinot are these little chocolate-covered ice cream capsules or whatever. And this is pretty fun. Look at this. It's shaped like a game controller. Bomber Pinot. It's got Bomberman, right? But they got their heads shaped like the Pinot. Actually, I don't think I've ever had these before. Never had these before. But I saw Bomberman. I'm like, all right, I gotta give this a shot. Hey, look at this. There's six of them. I'm gonna have to share these with my family. Oh. Wow. What's like? I want to say it's almost like gelato. It's kind of like really soft. Oh, that's good. Oh my gosh. I'm going to share this with my crazy family.
Christmas! Christmas!
Well, it is Christmas time. And Oroyoi. These are these yummy, very weak alcohol, kind of like a wine cooler type things, right? So we have red and green. The green is melon. This is cream soda sour melon. And this is cream soda sour strawberry. And the strawberry one actually has a little bit of fruit juice in it. The melon one does not. But the nice thing is that these are, you know, there's not a lot of coloring to them at all. They're pretty much clear. And they're pretty delicious. I did not have these with ice cream as depicted. I just drank them straight. But either way, it's pretty great. So, yeah, that's the end of 2023. So, Happy New Year, everyone, and I'll catch you in the next video. Bye. Hi there. I have supported YouTube since 2008, and while I have enjoyed being a member of the YouTube community these long years, this platform has made it clear that they do not support freedom of speech, diversity of thought, or honest scientific discussion. They have made it obvious that they would rather spend their effort on censoring voices of dissent rather than more pressing issues, such as preventing this platform from enabling totalitarianism and child exploitation. As a result, I am transitioning my content to Odyssey. So, if you enjoy and appreciate my content, but are wondering why I do not upload as often as I used to, I would encourage you to follow me to Odyssey, where you can find much more of my content on hobby interests and life in general. The link to my Odyssey channel should be in this video's description. Thank you for your understanding, and I hope you could join me in helping increase the hobbyist community on Odyssey.